You've seen us expose online predators.
I didn't come here for anything physical.
Men using the internet to arrange for sex with children.
She invited me over.
Now, the footage you haven't seen.
Are you going to call if you're coming or if you're not?
The defendant will commit future sex offenses.
From the heartland of America, more surprise confrontations.
BS talk got you sentenced to prison.
Bizarre behavior.
What were you doing with your pants there?
You ask if she does anal.
It's a question.
And busted suspects with nowhere to run.
They'll just be shot.
This is Predator Raw. When we first started this, I thought, we'd do two, maybe three investigations. And at some point, we'd have nothing but video of me pacing in a kitchen someplace. Guys would get the message and they'd stop showing up. We had been to locations for investigations that were near big metropolitan areas. We wanted to find out if this was also a problem in America's heartland. So we went to Dark County, Ohio, right near Greenville, Ohio. I think the county has a population of something like 13,000. And we set up to see what would happen. By the time the investigation was over, we learned that even in this little town in Ohio, this was a problem.
Put it down! Put your hands in the air!
Hands in the air!
Turn around! Turn around!
I'm gonna read you your rights. Do you have any questions?
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say, Kane, will be used against you in a court of law.
Then take a seat. Watch your head, okay? Watch your head.
In this case, as in the previous investigations, we worked with the computer watchdog group, Perverted Justice.
She's got the guy.
It's decoys going to chat rooms, posing as 12, 13, 14, 15-year-old kids, home alone, open to the idea of a sexual liaison in a meeting. But they go into chat rooms and they just wait. And they never make the first contact. And sometimes in a matter of minutes, a man is approaching them online. The online chat becomes sexual, and the next thing you know, a meeting is set.
I have a pen.
Come on in, man. I just whacked my toe on the banister.
Where are you?
I hit my toe on the banister. Oh, I gotta go get a Band-Aid. Now I'm bleeding, and I'm gonna get shot if I bleed on the rug. Hang out at the bar for a second. I'll be right back down, all right?
All right.
Sorry.
Because we were out in the country, these guys, in some cases, had to drive a couple hours or more. And Alonzo Wade was one of those guys. He turns towards the door, and he's doing something with the zipper. Now, I still, to this day, don't know exactly what his plan was. He might have been getting ready to go outside to relieve himself, or he might have, you know, been plotting something else. But he did pull down his zipper before he turned around and walked to the bar.
How are you tonight?
Fine.
Do me a favor and put a seat right around that stool.
Yes, sir.
Now, what were you doing with your pants there when you were heading towards the door? Were you hiding something in your pants?
No, there ain't nothing. Look, I'll show you everything.
Well, I don't... You didn't see everything.
Well, but... no, but well, now my zipper came down. Excuse me.
Well, you brought quite the selection tonight.
Yes, sir.
What do we have here?
Well, that's mine.
All of this is yours?
Yes, sir.
A lot of these guys are just trying to do their best to get out of a bad situation. So they're trying to make up their story on the spot. Alonzo Wade tried to tell me that this alcohol was for him.
And you just thought this would be a nice warm place to drink it?
Well, no, sir. I was talking to her online. She invited me over.
Yeah. And who is she?
What is it? Her online name? Bush Girl or something like that.
Bush Sucks Girl.
That's it.
That's it. And who are you?
Alonzo Hampton Wade. I'll show you my ID.
Alonzo Hampton Wade. And Alonzo, how old are you?
40. 40. I told her how old I was.
Yeah. And how old is she?
She told me she was 15.
15.
Yes, sir. I just wanted a place to drink. I wasn't going to do nothing.
You didn't have any place to drink, so you thought you'd come here?
Yes, sir.
Just to hang out and drink?
Yes, sir.
And you're
going
to drink?
No. Some of that was going home with me.
Some's going home?
Oh, yeah.
Were you going to give any to the 15-year-old?
Oh, no. I don't do that.
And you
I got a 15-year-old daughter myself.
You've got a 15-year-old daughter yourself?
Yes. I just wanted a place to sit and drink.
Why couldn't you drink at home?
Well, my daughter's got her friends there, and I don't like drinking in front of her.
So you thought you'd come over here and drink in front of another 15-year-old girl who's not your daughter?
No, that's not my intentions. my intentions was to not, my intentions was to drink in front of a
15-year-old girl.
Yes, I see what you're saying.
Does that make any sense?
No.
So why don't you tell me why you were really here?
To drink.
To drink.
Yeah.
All right. So now let me ask you this. You're here in this house where you believe a 15-year-old girl is home alone. You bring the booze into the house.
Right.
How would you feel if while you're over here, some 40-year-old guy is at your house bringing booze to your 15-year-old daughter and her friends?
Probably the same way you feel right now.
You tell me.
I'm saying probably the same way you feel right now.
So why is it okay for you to do it?
It ain't. And I don't know why I did it. I just wanted to party, that's all.
So just party.
Yeah.
And there's no 40-year-olds to party with. Well, nobody who's grown up who you can party with in the whole state of Ohio.
Well, I didn't say in the whole state, but go where I'm from.
Alonzo Wade tried to tell me that he was not there to have sex with a 15-year-old girl. Now, at some point, he cracks a little bit and says, well, maybe he would. And I say to him, well, what is it? Yes, no, maybe so.
It appears to be clear from this transcript that you are open to the idea of having sex with this girl.
No. Yes. Would I? No. Or maybe. All right. Maybe.
What is it, Alonzo? Yes, no, maybe so.
Maybe.
Maybe. So maybe you would have had sex with this girl.
Maybe. If she wanted sex and I was drunk enough, I'm not going to say I wouldn't. I'm not going to say I would. I can't say what I would do when I'm drunk.
Well, you know, I got to tell you that I'm Chris Hansen with Dateline NBC.
Oh, I understand.
And we're doing a story on adults going on the internet trying to hook up with teens.
Right.
Now,
you see the cameras coming in and everything.
Right. As we're finishing the interview, I say, you know, what do you think should happen to you?
I should go to jail.
Put it down! Put your hands in the air!
Turn around!
The Dark County Sheriff's Department in Ohio was running a parallel investigation. So when I finished talking to the men who arrived at our hidden camera house, they would leave and they would be arrested.
You have the right to talk to a lawyer and have him present during questioning if you wish. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Are you hiding some of these things?
No, there ain't nothing. Look, I'll show you everything.
I don't even see it.
Well, no, but now I'm a different game now. If she wanted sex and I was drunk enough, I'm not going to say I wouldn't. No, I don't.